My name is Jimmy Barrera. I work with Cimquest here in Branchburg, New Jersey. So I'm a senior product engineer. I have two main functions here. One of them is to create technical documentation, technical videos, and it's a lot of fun to do. I work with very talented people. My second function has to do with providing CAD services to our customers. A customer will come in and they'll have an idea, a concept, maybe written on a napkin or a piece of paper, and they'll ask us, can you do this in CAD and provide a prototype for us? The nice thing about Cimquest is that it's a one-stop shop. They come in with an idea, I'll sit with them, I'll create the CAD design for them, I'll produce the models for them, and ultimately they walk out, once we're all done, with a prototype of their idea in their hand. So it's very exciting to see these things happen from inception, from an idea to a final prototype, and many times to the end product. Okay, so about a year ago, we had the Atlanta Design and Manufacturing Show, which we attend every year. We have a pretty nice size booth. And Dave, the director of Stratus Sales here at Cimquest, came up to me and with the idea, and he said, hey Jim, could we create a Cimquest USB drive, something that has our logo on it? We can put our information on it, give it to the prospects when they visit us at the booth. I thought it was a great idea. We have all the technologies here, and that's how it all started. As far as the requirements, the first thing I thought of is, since you're going to be holding the USB stick, I want it to be ergonomic. You know, usually the USB sticks that you see on the shelf, they're just flat. It's just a square box, a rectangle, right? So I wanted mine to be different, so when you held it in your hand, it actually felt comfortable. My idea that is, if I created a twist on the actual shell of the USB, then it'll be more comfortable to hold in your hand. So another thing that I was concerned about, or one of my objectives with my design, besides ergonomics, was functionality. So when we take this USB and we plug it into a hub, would there be enough room for the one next to it, or maybe the one above or below it? So that's one thing I had to keep in mind. I had to take some measurements from different types of USB hubs. Another thing is, when you actually insert it into the USB hub, would it be easy to pull out? I noticed with some of the rectangular ones, the box-looking ones, sometimes you have to grab it pretty hard and fidget with it. So I wanted some kind of handle or curve on it to accomplish this part of the functionality of the USB. Additionally, I was worried about how this was going to assemble together. Obviously, this was going to be created in two pieces, so I can put the USB guts in there and then maybe clamp them both together. In your mind, everything sounds great, but then when you put it in CAD, you know, you get to test it, and it's only when you prototype it that you really get to test your ideas to see if they're practical at all in the real world. The best part was, because we have 3D printing, we have that technology available to us in-house, what I would do is I would incorporate an idea that I had and then print it. 30 minutes later, I had the end part. And I would look at it, test it. It wasn't quite what I wanted. Then I would go ahead and print it again. 30 minutes later, I had the new prototype in my hand. And this kind of iterative process was fantastic. I was able to see almost real time. I would make the changes in CAD, and then I would have the product in my hand just a short while later. I can say in one day, maybe I would go through 8 to 10 iterations of this design. A great time saver, if you ask me. So we use a Conex 260, and that allowed us to print the white material, which is very nice and glossy, and also fuse the letters of the logo and also the information in one build. I went back to CAD. 30 minutes later, I was able to come up with a very quick fixture using the mold tools, some complex surfacing. And so I came up with this structure here. You can see how there's room for 5 of them. So Tom said, Jim, you missed 1 degree of freedom. It's solid up and down. It's solid forward and back. But side to side, there's really nothing to locate it or to clock it. Again, that's something that you really, it's hard to catch everything unless you have a prototype. I went back to CAD and made the fix. I just added a couple of bevels here, like a taper, top and bottom. And now if you see, it has a nice click to it. And I left a little bit of clearance just so the clamps can squeeze the top and bottom halves together. So this was the final product here, and prototyping was very happy with me. So as far as designing the shell around the USB guts, right? We purchased a bunch of USB guts, all boxed up together. And in order to test if there was any interference with my design of the USB shell, I had a model of the USB gut in CAD, and I took my USB shell model, I put them together in the assembly, I did some interference checks, and the great thing is 3D printing is so accurate nowadays. When I printed out my first model and I put it together and it snapped together over the USB gut, it was really a slip fit. It was perfect. Just the way I saw it in CAD, I printed it, and even the tolerances I used for the little shelves and for the lip and groove feature, for the snap features in here, we're talking about something that's tiny. It was very impressive. Anybody that has CAD, you can only do so much with the CAD technology. You can do your design, you can test, you can do a flow analysis, you can do an FEA, you can see if there's interference between your parts in the assembly. But there's a lot of questions that cannot be answered with CAD, even though it's very advanced. You can't tell how it feels in your hand. You can't tell how it finally looks when you put this product on a shelf, when you finally start to use this product. Is it actually practical? And these are the kind of things that prototyping did for me. You know, I think to myself, we do this kind of stuff for fun. You know, we have all the technologies available. We have the 3D printing, we have CAD, we have the materials accessible to us. But I asked myself, how do companies that have deadlines to meet do it? How do companies that produce ideas and take them to market, how do they do it if they don't have 3D printing? How much time is wasted? How much money is wasted by having to wait for other people or by having bottlenecks in their process? This is a solution. This is indispensable. This is an integrated part of design. You design something and you validate it through 3D printing. And companies that do that, I have seen, have been very, very successful. By the time you get to tooling, by the time you get to manufacturing, there is no doubt in your mind that you have a great product.